Hi, welcome everyone. Welcome to another episode of Make Marketing Yours. And today I have a very special guest here with me, and she is Shelly Criswell. And she actually went from feeling stuck in her career that she hated into working as a full-time virtual assistant. And now she actually being her own boss and finally living the life that she will love, like she always dreamt of. So Shelly, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me, Vanessa.
That's excellent. So Shelly, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, so I went to school for medical technology. So my original career was working in like a lab in a hospital setting. And I did that for 20 years and just got really tired of working in hospitals on like weekends and holidays and not getting to be with my family, working those crazy hours, and discovered the world of virtual assistant. And I was like, what? You can do this from home? So yeah, I just started digging into that more and grew that as a side hustle while I worked in the lab for about a year. And then I finally got to the point where I was able to quit the lab and do VA work full time.
That is excellent. So basically the reason why you left your corporate job will be more like looking for flexibility and more like work-life balance, right?
Yes, yes. I have two kids at home and I just really wanted to, you know, let them do things after school if they wanted, and so I could pick them up or, you know, anything like that and just be with them more. So that was the main reason.
Yeah, I love the flexibility as well, because sometimes the school just call you, and if you want to do some volunteer work and, you know, or excursion, that you can actually participate. It's really good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just this week, my daughter called and had to come home sick, and I just, you know, went and got her. I didn't have to ask anybody if I could leave or, exactly. Yeah, just so thankful for that.
Exactly. So how do you feel about losing like a stable income? So because for me, it is like a scary thing. Like the first couple of months, you sort of like cruising along, enjoying. But after a few months, you start thinking of like, you don't have the stable income coming in. So what did you feel?
Yeah, that is quite a terrifying thing. But, you know, even with a job at a corporation, you could be let go at any second. It's not ever really guaranteed. And at least if you're an entrepreneur, to me, I can kind of see things coming. I can kind of tell this client, you know, may not want to stick with me, or, and you can put into your contract, you know, a minimum of 3 months or a 30-day notice or something like that. So you do have notice. So yeah, I was speaking to someone this week that, was let go of her job unexpectedly. And now is going to try to get into the VA world. So you never know. Nothing's guaranteed.
That is so true, because the company can actually make you redundant, right? You just have mm-hmm. to have like a plan for it. So as an entrepreneur myself, I know how difficult it is to actually stay above the water. People think running your own business is easy. It's actually not. You're actually working like long hours. You really have to have the determination to do that. So how did you overcome all of these things? Like family, yeah. You know, your client, work-life balance?
Yeah, that's hard. Well, it's funny, the year that I decided to start the side hustle, I was also working with a life coach. So I think that really helped my mindset and actually gave me the confidence to go after that. I think without doing that mindset work first, I would not have been able to. And just to continue with that mindset work, it really goes a long way.
Yeah, for that's sure. Very interesting, because a lot of people think that mindset is not really important. It doesn't drive you like traffic. It doesn't give you leads. But the mindset is very important for entrepreneur, because you have like ups and downs. So I yes. think being like have a positive mindset is very important.
Yeah, yeah. And just knowing where your strengths are and, you know, where you can trip up, and to know it's okay to fail, you know, just learn from those and keep going and all those great things.
Yeah, exactly. So you talk about VA, because a lot of people don't know what virtual assistant actually means. Can you tell us a little bit more about what is a VA and what does a VA do?
Yeah, so we're all mostly independent contractors. There are some VA agencies out there that you could hire, but for the most part, we're independent contractors. You can hire us to do, there are so many different types of VAs, bookkeeping, proofreading, blog writing, copywriting, newsletter, email management, inbox management, Pinterest or podcast management. There's like anything that you could do in a, at a computer, you could hire a VA for, basically. And a lot of my clients, they're all over the United States. So you don't have to be local, which makes it nice. You don't have to pay them benefits. You don't have to have an office space for them. And they're contracted, so you don't have to, they're not like an employee. And so, you know, you can do one-off projects or hire them for ongoing things. So it's quite flexible, actually.
Yeah, but I think it's actually quite difficult to actually find a good VA. So do you have any tips for us? Like, how do you, like, pre sort of qualify them, whether they would be good fit to your business?
Yeah, that's a great question. I may, you know, maybe work with them for a couple of weeks without any kind of, you know, guarantee to stay on, just to see how you would do, or ask for references, or portfolio, an example of their work. Definitely, I like working with clients just more like the relationship with the client. So I like to meet with them on Zoom a couple of times before we start, just to see, you know, how our personalities match. But yeah, and now I'm starting to get, most of my clients are referral based. So yeah, if you know of any fellow entrepreneurs that have a VA and ask them, you know, for referrals, that's a good way to go too.
Right. So do you find it actually difficult to work with some female entrepreneur, because like some people just don't want to let go of like sort of style, you know, even though they tell you sort of like what they want, but when you actually deliver or have the first draft ready, they're not quite like, you know, how do you deal with those?
Yeah, that's hard. You have to really, sometimes those kind of relationships take a while. You have to gain their trust and just be understanding that it's hard for them to let go. I completely understand. I would have a hard time too. But then, you know, it takes time. I have a client now, they had a really hard time letting go and asking for help. But now, I mean, we've been together 6 months now, and it's great. They have no problem giving me work now.
It's about how you work with this client, because at the beginning, like, it's more like a testing stage, because you don't know what sort of expectation they are, and they don't know how to work it. So it's sort of like testing, you know, and trying to work together.
Yeah, definitely. And just have an open communication and staying in contact, you know, don't get a project and then like ghost them for a week.
Yeah. Do you have a team of like a VA working with you? Or if someone wants to hire your VA or hire you, how do they do?
Yeah, so I have a website, and you can also find me on Member Vault, and you could just email me. And I do have one extra person working with me on my team. She's a graphic designer. I'm not the best at graphic design, and I know that about me, but I don't want that to deter people from hiring me as their VA. So I have an excellent graphic designer on my team, and that's another great thing that you can do is, like, you know, if there are areas that you're not great at, just hire somebody to be on your team, and then you can offer a full service to the clients.
Excellent. So what type of VAs are hot in the market right now, and like who's everyone's want?
Yeah, it seems like everybody wants those social media managers.
Yes, it could be a tough one.
Yeah, I mean, that social media takes up a lot of time for sure, and copywriting I think is a very special gift that I was not granted. So I don't do copywriting, but those are definitely hot commodities right now.
Yeah, true. So yeah, there's only two things that I don't do in my business is SEO and also copywriting. And when you talk about copywriting, it's just like, so for the people, like, let's say in different countries, even though we all speak English, but I think the English will be slightly different with American English, Australian English, or British English. So if someone wants to hire a copywriter, do you have any advice for them, like looking for maybe like a locals copywriter? Is that better?
Yeah, I would definitely stay within your region, just so that Because the great thing about a copywriter is they are really good at writing in your voice. And so, yeah, if they're not even writing in the same type of English or language, then it's going to definitely come across.
Yeah, definitely. Fair enough. So what is your best advice you can give to our listener if they are thinking of leaving their corporate job and start a virtual assistant?
Oh, yeah, that's my favorite thing to talk about because it can seem so overwhelming and you don't know where to start. But really, it's not that hard. You just pick one thing you want to learn, and there are so many resources online. And then you kind of think about what are you good at right now. There's so many skills that you could bring to a VA job right now that you have in your current job. You just don't even realize. And when I first started out, I would take some one-off projects and I would do it for free in exchange for testimonials and just for the experience. So I did do that a lot. And that was very helpful. And I even got a client from one of those. She really liked my work so much, she just went ahead and hired me. So that was pretty cool. Yeah. And then just slowly learn, you know, things that you want to learn. There are so many Facebook groups out there to join and ask questions and network with people, other people that are going through the same thing. So there's a lot of resources out there.
Excellent. So is there something that you can actually help for people, like if they want to become a virtual assistant, is there something that you can help them with?
Yeah, so I do currently have a course. It's called Ditch Your 9-to-5 Quick Start Toolkit. And it's just meant to give you the nitty gritty. This is what you need to do to get started, to be legal, you know, open your own bank account, that sort of thing. And then I also have some tech trainings in there because I think tech scares a lot of people. And you know, so I give you the main things most people want you to know about and train you in those as well. I love tech, so that's
so a lot of entrepreneurs are actually scared of tech. So which is so this is more like a group coaching, right?
Yes, it's a group coaching. It's a self-paced course, so you can, you know, go as fast or slow as you need to. And then there is a Facebook group that you can be a part of, and weekly calls, Q&A calls. So,
right.
Yeah. So
now, as a VA, like if you more like doing execution for entrepreneur, but do you also do one-on-one coaching if someone wants to be a virtual assistant? Is it something that you can help them with, like one-on-one?
Yeah, I could definitely do that. That would be so fun.
That is good to know. And you have a bunch of free resources, right? Where can people find those?
Yeah, so it is, help me out here. Is it VIP Member Vault?
VIP Member Vault, yes.
So it's elevateyourbestlife.vipmembervault.com. Is that
yes,
it?
Yes. So what I'll do, I will put all your links like in the show notes so people can actually access all your free resources, because I think you've got a lot of free resource in there, and also to your course as well. What is the name of the course? Ditch Your 9-to-5?
Yes, Ditch Your 9-to-5.
Excellent. So I think a lot of people are actually interested in hire a VA, or they want to be a VA, because it seems they're more like a stepping stone from leaving the corporate world and to set up their own business. So it's more like a transition. They can be doing something in between.
Oh, as a VA, yeah. Like a side hustle, or yeah, you could definitely like any kind of like admin job on the side virtually. That will definitely get your foot in the door.
Excellent. So thank you so much for sharing with us today, Shelly.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. And I'll speak to you soon.
Okay.